Disadvantages of MNCs for the host country. Disadvantages of MNCs for the host countries. So now we learn about the what is the first disadvantage. So here these MNCs will transfer. These MNCs are transfer their technology. They will transfer their technology which is outdated in their home country, and they will be transferred that outdated technology to the host country. Which is outdated technology in the home country, then they will transfer that to the home country. Their host country. So that is what the difference. That is what the most disadvantages of this MNCs for the host countries. So your host countries will get that technology which is outdated in that home country. Next. And the MNCs do not operate within the national autonomy, and because the MNCs are not because for the host countries, the MNCs do not operate in the national autonomy. So their national control is not there on them. So definitely it will be threat. It gives rise to the threat of economic and political sovereignty of that host countries, because here their main autonomy is the other country, because they won't come under the control of our country, because they are just a host countries. So with that, definitely it will be big threat. It will causes threat to the economic and political sovereignty of that host country. It will causes damages to the economy and political sovereignty of that host country. So that is what the disadvantages. And not only that, it will kill the domestic industries, because as I told, MNCs will conduct in large scale operations. So domestic countries, they cannot allocate investments, they cannot allocate the, because they are very less, they will conduct in very less economic operations. With that, definitely they can't compete with these MNCs. With that, definitely with the introduction of MNCs into that host countries, here there will be no industry, there will be no domestic industries. So here the domestic industries will die. So the domestic industries will get into losses. So here they can't compete with the MNCs. That is what the main advantages. And not only that, MNCs uses natural resources of home countries. So they will come here with the use of, because they, for their profits, MNCs for their profits, they will use the natural resources of host countries. Natural resources of host countries. And with that, definitely in the host countries, there will be a decrease of that natural resources. There will be a depletion of natural resources occurs. So that is what. So but profits will be taken by the home countries. Profits will be taken by the home countries of the MNCs, but here they will get the depletion. So that is what the advantage. And not only that, here money flows to the foreign countries in terms of payments toward the profits, dividends and royalties. And as I told, MNCs companies, they will take their profits, dividends, royalties to here. Money flows from here, the host countries to that countries. Whatever we have acquired, whatever the profits we have got from this host country, so they will take that money to their country, home countries. So here there will be money flow to another country, money flow to foreign countries. These are the advantages, these are the disadvantages of this MNCs for the host country. So now we'll move forward to the another disadvantages of MNCs for the home countries. What are the disadvantages for the home countries? What are the disadvantages causes to the home countries? So here the main problem will be, here the home country transfer, the MNCs will transfer capital from home country to host country. They will transfer their capital from home country to host countries, causing unfavorable balance of payment. So when they transfer their capital from home country to host country, there will be the problem of unfavorable balance of payment. And not only that, it may not get, the home country may not create the So as I told, the MNCs may not create the employment opportunities, because they always want to give the employment opportunities in the host countries only. They don't create the opportunities, because the employment opportunity will be lost by the home countries. So that is how the problem. So that is how the problem created, because they always want to they will always use that system of geocentric approach. They will follow that geocentric approach. So here they may not give the employment opportunities in the home countries. They always give the employment opportunities in the host countries only. So that is a problem arises. And not only that, because investing in host countries is more profitable, because if they do their operations in the other countries, host countries, it will be very profitable. With that effect, they tend to neglect the home countries industrial development and economic development. That is how it causes. That is the disadvantage of this MNCs for the home country. MNCs for the home countries. So they will neglect the industrial sector and economic development of that home country. That is what the problem, because that is not a profitable. So if we invest in a home country, definitely that is not profitable. If we go beyond the home country, definitely that is profitable. But what happens? It will kill the economic and industrial development of that home country. So that is what happens. So these are the disadvantages of MNCs for the host country and the home countries. So this is the end of this MNC.